I'm scared. Okay. Let's go. Hi guys. I hope you're all well. I am potentially starting this channel, but I don't want to say I'm starting a YouTube channel because I can't be committed to doing loads of videos. But I am starting this, I guess, new little journey, side hustle, I don't know what you want to call it, with some dance photography. And over the next couple of weeks, I've got some really cool shoots booked in, and I kind of just want to document them, kind of for myself. Just kind of document my journey, see how it goes. If you don't see any more after the first couple, we know how it went. Hopefully it doesn't do that, I really hope. But yeah, I've always loved photography. One of my favourite things, I did it at college, I did it as part of my uni course, and I get to do a little bit of work but not like my own, so yeah. A little bit of background to me is I've danced my whole life, I still dance now, so yeah, I mean that kind of works. Photography passion, I love to dance, makes dance photography. So yeah, I'm basically just got myself ready for work. And yeah, I've got a shoot booked this afternoon with a girl I used to go to school with and her sister, and I'm really excited. It's gonna be quite a like a jazz contemporary kind of shoot, and we're going to our like town, and there's some really cool like underpasses with like rainbow tiles, and I'm like, that is the vibe I'm here for. Very street style, very like brick walls, that type of vibe. So we will see. Also, I want to do these videos because I want to talk about kind of like the settings I use and the camera I'm using, and if there are any fellow, why is my voice going? Any fellow photographers out there that can give me advice on how to get better shots, better settings to make it look better, I would love to hear it. Honestly, please give me all your advice, I need it. I've learned a lot from school and college and uni. However, I've also kind of self-taught myself. So I'd really like all your advice, please. So I'm at work now. I'm going to work now from 9 to 5. And my shoot's at 5. Which is so good. And I'm so excited. And it's going to get me through the day. Right. Let's go to work. I am just kind of packing my bag for work. Obviously, I have my bag, like, my work essentials. But I have my camera. Hello. Which is the Canon DSLR 1200D, which is my little baby. I would love to upgrade, as much as it's my little baby, I would love to upgrade it at some point, which has the standard lens, which I kind of use majority of the time because then I get a lot wider shot. However, I have a 50mm lens that I got for uni when I was doing a lot of portrait photography. I do just like to take this along with me just in case it comes in handy. I know some girls that I shoot, they quite like headshots or like headshot vibes, so it's always good to have on me. So I've got that. My SD cards are full, not full, my SD cards are empty, so yeah, but I just don't think I've got enough space in my bag and it's really stressing me out. And I have to walk to work after I parked and my bag is so heavy. It's not okay. This is not going to work. Right, new bag acquired. Smaller, I know, doesn't make sense, but it's just a massive pocket and I can have it on me while I shoot, so that makes sense in my head. Let's go to work. Okay, so the shoot is done. It went so well. The girls are so lovely. I literally love them. So yeah, so you'll have seen in my little clips that I did. Am I in focus? Yeah. So you'll see in those clips that I just took that we went to the like rainbow tile underpass, which was really cool. Quite tricky with the settings, I found. I just kept playing around. Hopefully post-production will be all good. And then we're just down a couple of alleyways, bit dodged, lots of strange looks, but it's fine. It's all the fun of it. But yeah, went really well. So I cannot wait to edit these. Oh my God. Welcome to editing Brie. She wears no makeup and looks mess, but it's fine. I have just gone through the photos and I'm like happy and not happy, I guess. I'm like 50-50. Some photos look really nice. I'm really happy with them and I know when I edit them, they'll be really nice. But some have not come out as well as I'd hoped. Like I said yesterday, it was quite dark where we were shooting. So, I wasn't sure how they were gonna come out, but yeah, some of them are a bit grainy. I think it's because my ISO was too high. But then I was trying to like make sure it was light and not pitch black. So yeah, maybe I need to do some more research into that. But if you guys have any idea, please let me know. I'd really love to learn. But I think they're not wasteable. I could definitely use them. I think I could put like a film effect on it so it looks like old school. Yeah, so we'll see. We'll have a try. Just kind of talk through the edit I'm doing so far. I always prefer to like knock the highlights down straight away and put the shadows up. I feel like I can see the picture more clearer. And then I kind of just have a play around really, kind of just drag them up and down the scale, see what I think looks better. I'm gonna bring the exposure down a tinsy bit. I feel like it's so much clearer and the highlights down because that sky is so bright. Contrast down a tint, but then I like to put the black point up just to really like her black jacket and boots. I feel like with the black point up, you can really see it. Obviously, I like to just boost the vibrancy just to make her pop. Then I'm going ahead and just bring the warmth down a tinsy bit to get it, I feel like it looks a bit more grungy. And then I just take the temperature and I just knock it down a tinsy bit. And then with the curves, honestly, I just have a play around. I don't really know if someone could explain it. I really need to Google curves and what works, but I just have a play. Yeah, I feel like that's nice. Just brighten it up a bit. You can see her more now. And then I love, for dance photos, I love to add a vignette because I just think it focuses on her. There we go. Let's see the before and after. Oh. Yes, please. I love that.
So I realised I am rubbish and didn't finish my first video. Good start, Brie. So it's the next day. I have edited all the photos that you would have just seen and I've sent them across to the girls and they have been so lovely and they really like them. So I'm so glad. And I said to them, I said, we can do another shoot so we can make up for the ones that didn't go quite as planned. But, you know, it's all in the learning process. So yeah. I'm still happy and I'm glad they like them and there's definitely some in there that I really love. But yeah, so I went on another shoot this morning, which you will see in my next video. Yeah, I can't wait to share them all with you. But yeah, here are all the photos from this shoot.